Okay, here we are once again on the weekend, S&S Turbines, building up the J47 for an F-86F Sabre. Now, we've added a couple things since the last time you've seen it. This is the auxiliary drive gearbox. It's a gearbox with an oil supply here and a scavenge pump on the back that drains it. And this is actually the unconnected scavenge line. Pumps it back to the return. It returns it back to the accessory gear case, which we saw previously. Way back here. This drive housing is what mounts on the front of that shaft. There's the starter in there. We've mocked everything up to make sure that it fits because it's a very tight fit. And if I did everything right, these splines will turn when I turn the rotor. So let's zoom in on that and we'll give it a go. I'm gonna reach in, turn the main rotor of the engine. You watch this guy, see if it turns. We're turning in the direction the engine would be going if it was running. And I'll try not to slice my fingers off. It looks like it's turning. I believe it turns at engine speed. One of these is a hydraulic pump and the other one drives a alternator or another hydraulic pump depending on the configuration of the aircraft. But the main electrical power is given by the starter because it's not just a starter, it's a starter generator. There's no clutch between the starter and the engine. Once the engine starts, it keeps spinning the starter, and then the starter then acts as a generator to supply electrical power to the aircraft. It's one way of saving weight. All right, so these two leads here, they would be speed indicators for the two accessories there. This is a cover plate for the drive shaft that joins into a spline in the back of this gearbox here. This is labeled flight control. I honestly don't know what it does. This is the main fuel filter. It's a high pressure filter. And we've got the center fairings in place, not bolted in place. The islands, these are what are known as islands, and the island strut fairings are right, they go right here. We haven't got one on yet because they're the last thing that goes in. And we've got one sector, which is the top one, installed, and you can see those are the retractable inlet screens that we will be using when we test this engine. It's almost there. We're just waiting for our starter spline adapter. We can take all this off and put it all back on again. For real.